Hi, I'm Matt Kelland, one of the founders of Moviestorm. In the next few minutes, I'm going to show you how to make a movie with Moviestorm, and we'll show you some of the things it can do. Now, there's a lot more than I can possibly cover here, so if you want more details on any of the features we're looking at, please go to the Moviestorm website. There's a whole load of video tutorials there which will give you much more information. Basically, there are six phases to making a movie. Building your set, creating your characters, directing, filming, editing, and then finally rendering. If you're familiar with video games, you'll find the way that Moviestorm does a lot of these things quite familiar to you. It's not like a traditional animation tool, it's much more like being on a film set. Anyway, let's get right on and we'll start with set building. Moviestorm gives you a variety of ready-made sets you can customize, or you can start from scratch if you prefer. You've got interiors, exteriors, spaceships, even some well-known locations, and you wouldn't be allowed to film here, for example. Once you've made a set, you can save it and use it again in your other movies. Now let's load up this one, the London Loft. Now most of this is the kind of thing you'd expect, but here's a few things to note. You can drag the props around and put them at any angle. You're not limited to a grid. And you can add new props. There's a handy tag system to help you find things. If I put this light on the set, you can see how we can easily change the lighting in different ways. Set up the colour, and put the light where we want it. And notice also how the shadows are moving. You can customise and rescale most props, like this picture. With things like pictures and video screens, you can also add your own images or videos. The props you have will depend on what packs you've got. You're not limited to what you can get from Moviestorm. You can create your own props and import them with Modders Workshop, or you can import props from Google SketchUp. You can also get packs from Modders. Some are free, some you have to pay for. Just look around and see what's available. Okay, so let's move straight on to creating characters. This is all going to be very familiar to you. It's just a matter of how much time you want to spend and how much detail you want to put in. Now this works like nearly every game and avatar creation system out there, so we won't spend long on this. Moviestorm has a large selection of costumes you can choose and customise. You can change the patterns and the colours. You can also mod your own if you want more variety. You can change the faces very easily using these sliders. You can get quite extreme results if that's what you want. You can change the skin colour, eyebrows, beards and so on. Many of the hairstyles are also customizable using the same simple slider method and color options. And then finally, accessorize. It's all very much the kind of thing you're probably used to. Okay, now I'm going to quickly add in another ready-made character from my stock, and then we'll get on the set and we'll start directing. First, let's get these guys in place. Just one click and they're on the set. And let's just move her to face the right way. Now let's start by getting them walking. Just click, and off he goes. You can see he opens the door automatically on his way. And we have these customization options here, so you can easily change the speed, the way he walks, and so on. Now let's move in a bit closer here. Moviestorm characters can interact with each other. Here's the sort of thing they can do. And props work the exact same way, like this chair. We have a lot of control over the exact animation, so let's make him slouch. One major feature of Moviestorm is how easy it is to make characters speak and act, so let's switch to Hayley for this bit. Click on her and we can see her acting options. So first, let's make her talk. Now, I could record straight into Moviestorm, but instead I'm going to use a line I pre-recorded earlier, so I can get a female voice. I'm going to type in the line so this next bit works better, and also increase the lip movement so you can see it better.
Hey John, do you want to go out for dinner?
Now you can see her mouth moves automatically. You don't have to do anything. Moviestorm does it all for you. She's got two sets of animations she can perform. These, the big posture changes. The gesturizer is a very powerful animation tool that allows you to combine many animations at once. So let's make a shrug. We just click and add it in. And also we'll do a second animation at the same time. We'll get her to tilt her head. So here we go.
Hey, John, do you want to go out for dinner?
And there she is, doing several things at once. Now let's complete the sequence by getting her to look at John.
Hey, John, do you want to go out for dinner?
And finally, I can change her mood. We don't have to do anything gamey to make her happy first. There's a variety of preset options or advanced tools if you need them. The characters will then improvise appropriately so you don't have to add in every little detail. And fundamentally, that's the essence of directing. You just keep layering in moves, gestures, dialogue, and so on until you've built up your whole scene. And the longer you spend on it, the more detail you put in, the better it's going to look. And of course, the great thing is that you don't actually have to know anything about animation at all. Because you're working with a library of ready-made animations, you're just putting them together in new and different and interesting ways, and it's just like directing, you're telling an actor what to do. Anyway, now, let's move on and we'll start filming it. This is where Moviestorm is quite different to a game or an animation tool. Filming in Moviestorm is very easy when you get used to it. I'll start with a shot on Haley. I select one of these ready-made shots, and then drag it around using the framing lines and scroll wheel till it looks right. Now, don't worry about where the camera is or trying to move like you're in a game. Just think about what's on the screen. There's also controls for different lenses, focus, and so on. So, here's the opening shot. Now I'll go forward a bit and create a camera move. As before, I set up the shot with the framing lines, and this time I'll use the move control. And this is what I get. Now I want to cut to John. Start with a shot on him and move it around until I'm happy. I'm going to swing round so I avoid getting the edge of the set out of the door. That'll do. As you can see, it now cuts to the new shot. The camera's going to follow John, but it ends up in a slightly odd place, so I'm going to put in another move, and it'll be better when he sits down. That's more like it. And finally, I want to cut back to Haley when she speaks. Now I can just reuse the framing I made before, so it's only going to take a couple of clicks to put in that shot. Now, there's a couple more things I want to show you before we move on. Moviestorm can actually create 3D movies, so here's a preview of what it would look like. If you had your 3D glasses on right now, this would be jumping out at you, but that's enough of that. I'm actually going to change the look of the movie using a different tool. This script window in the top right has a setting for cell shading, which gives it a cartoon look. I'll turn that on and... yeah, this works well for this scene, so I'll keep it. It takes some people a while to get the hang of filming in Moviestorm, but once you've got it, you'll find that it's fast, easy, and extremely powerful. Now let's move on to the final stages. I'm going to use the auto-generate tool to add in all my shots. It also makes placeholders for titles and credits. I don't like that title though, so I'm going to delete it and pick one of my own. This works in much the same way as most basic video editors. So so I can resize it, pick a font, and so on. I'm going to add in a subtitle the same way. Just drag it to the timeline.
Hey John, do you want to go out for...
Put in the text. And I'll customize the default credit too. Moviestorm offers a selection of video filters that gives you a variety of visual effects. I don't think I need any of these though. I like the way it looks as it is. I do want some music though. Moviestorm has several music packs, and I'll pick a track from one of these and then drag it to the audio line. I'm going to turn the volume down, or it'll drown out the dialogue. And I'll just trim the end off here. Then finally, I'll go to the publisher's view and render the movie. The custom option gives you control over the resolution, frame rate, 3D, codec, and so on. But I'm just going to use one of these fast presets so we can see something quickly. Now, one huge advantage of Moviestorm is you don't have to stick to this rigid way of working. You can go back and change your set, change the costumes, add in extras, give more direction, redo the dialogue, add in more camera angles and re-edit it. It's a very flexible way of working. Effectively, you start by building an animated storyboard, complete with edits and audio. You can then go back and use that as the basis for the final movie, whether you're working in live action or whether you're finishing off in Moviestorm. Anyway, let's have a look at what we've got so far. It's no Oscar winner, but it's got all the basics.
Hey, John, do you want to go out for dinner?
And that's just the start of what Moviestorm can do. There's a lot I didn't even touch on. For example, you can use it for car chases, action scenes, big crowd scenes. You can even go to exotic locations that you couldn't possibly do in real film without a decent budget. You can make music videos, you can make documentaries, commercials, training videos, feature films, video blogs, pretty much whatever you can imagine. Anyway, have fun exploring Moviestorm, and thanks for watching.